Okay. Hey, girls. Bye-bye, get back in there. This is a temporary house. Hey, girls. They're getting big. Look at the size. Whoa. Look at the size of these things. Okay, guys. I'm in the garage. Not really. Just stopping by. How you doing, girl? Nah, just doing some white yard work. Excuse me. Ah, something tickled my throat. Humidity's actually down. Just can't make it out. So, just taking a break. Let's sit down and talk. How's it going, guys? Just out here watering the lawn. It's due for some mowing. Lawn's actually doing good this year. We've been getting on and off like heavy rains. Every couple of days we'll get like a heavy rain and we'll clear like this, which is nice. So, I've only watered a handful of times, but I got this right here. And no, this is not going to be a religious video, so don't turn, freak, run. The only reason I'm showing you this is this particular place holds a car show once a week. And it's basically run by the people that are trying to get a drag strip back on Long Island. So they got trailers set up, all advertisement, and the stuff that rolls in there is really, I'd say 80% of it is cars that shouldn't have plates on them. We stopped by there yesterday, me, Mike, and Steve, to check it out. It's actually across the street from Steve's house and over, just, I don't know, you're lucky any, a 16th of a mile. So, they hold the show from 6 to 9, and at 9 o'clock it moves down the road if you want to continue on, because at that point they lock up the gates to the place. You know, there's like one of those bars in front. I was handed this. Doesn't that look like Pauly Jr.? I think it does. But whatever. No, I was handed this during the night, and I just held it the whole night. It was sitting in my chair here. So, I didn't get much video. I did make a video of Steve's engine on the block. And, yeah, that thing has problems. That thing has problems, to say the least. One of the problems, I'll show you the picture, is the wrist pin warped. It actually had a loose fit into the rod. Okay, Steve says he couldn't push it with his fingers, but if he tapped it lightly, it slid right in the rod. So he didn't look to see if the rod cracked, if the pin was machined wrong, didn't matter at that point. But the block has the shape of the wrist pin up and down for a couple hundred miles. And that was just one of the problems. He had the block sent out, he had it bored, tanked, you know, all the stuff you have done. I had the heads done. And he did the assembly of the engine. But he had them put the cam bearings in. And two of the cam bearings spun. And I looked at them. And to me it looks like they didn't line up the holes. So maybe they have an apprentice in the shop, like a novice in the shop, somebody in the shop. Maybe it was the first time putting cam bearings in, whoever did it. But the rear one, the hole is 90% lined up. The front and second one, front one has two holes, they're lined up, second one's lined up. The third one, you can't identify where the hole was because it starved for oil immediately, and the hole got closed, so I don't even know where it is. The fourth one in, the hole does not line up. It didn't spin, but the hole is covered with Babbitt, but you can make it out, and I can see it's not lined up. It's off by a little bit, not that much. So it was only the third one that actually spun and walked towards the front of the engine by a good eighth of an inch. So, he was going to have trouble regardless. So, I'm not sure what the outcome is right now, what he's doing. He had it in the back of his El Camino. He was running it by a machine shop. I mean, they could sleeve it. They punch it out, they sleeve it, then they deck it. Then they bring that sleeve to whatever size pistons the rest of the bores are, which I think are 30 over, I think. It didn't look like there was any damage to the block with a cam bearing spun. Usually there isn't, unless it becomes locked and fused to the cam. Then there could be problems, but that isn't what happened. The cam was definitely stiff coming out, but it wasn't locked to it. On the other hand, it might have been locked to the cam, and the stiffness that Steve felt was that bearing slide to 16th of an inch, then it released. So it might have never actually slid forward. It might not have slid forward till Steve did that. You could see the clean line where it was. So, with that said, we will be venturing back there Tuesday. I didn't bring my car because I didn't know what the situation was. It's 10 minutes from where I work. And for me to come home here and then go back there in bumper-to-bumper traffic at rush hour, it took me an hour to get there. An hour to do not even 20 miles. So, yeah, that's a definite waste. But it's easier to just go to Steve's house and hang out there till it starts. But by the time I get there, I'm sure it'll be started. And then when I'm done with my car, I can just drive it back and then drive home. It's on the way home. So, we're hitting up cruise night tomorrow. We're going to do a bunch of them. I just need to relax for a week. Not that I'm actually relaxing. I'm actually getting stuff accomplished. Between me and Junior and knocking out the normal household stuff. I don't mean inside stuff, I mean like maintenance and whatever. And you can see this is due. Well, like I said, the room's growing pretty quick. So we'll probably mow that up Friday. So it's good for the weekend. But yeah, so we're going to take a little break from the Concorde for a couple days. And we'll go back on it. And every once in a while you need a break because it becomes overwhelming. And when you step back into it, you say to yourself, holy moly, I didn't realize I was so far in. That, you know, I got a lot more done than I thought. And looking in there, that's the way I feel. Especially when I look at the older pictures. And I see just the first picture of Junior Sand in the one fender, all bolted on. And I realize how much work I did to that left front door, how much work I did to the right front door, how much work I did to that corner, how much work Junior did stripping this thing. You know, we gotta go over this in a fine tooth comb, make sure there's no rust that I could find anywhere. A lot of the stuff you see on here, anything that's etched, is gonna get sanded back down anyway. I'm just gonna be very careful around the Bondo areas, and I'm hoping that I don't have to get too deep in with metal glaze to straighten the car out. So I'm sure it's gonna be more body work. And that's basically what's going on. I guess that's about it. So I'm just sitting out here enjoying this. I'm not getting bit by bugs, not yet. So there's just enough breeze, but not where I'm sitting. I'm like being blocked. Oh, I got the sprinkler in the blurry spot. Yeah, I'm getting a lot of comments on Facebook about I have to clean my lens. Everybody knows my lens is bad. Everybody knows I'm cheap. Everybody knows there's a lot going on. So the last thing on my mind is buying a camera. I got normal things I gotta take care of first. You will see a video probably within the next couple of weeks. I gotta do an AC unit in this house. The AC unit took a poop. So it's leaking to the point where it doesn't pay to repair it. It's so old. I mean, I'm in the house 23 years. 23 years ago, it looked like a relic. So, and we thought that would be the only year we were gonna use it because the drain pan had rotted. So we got 23 years out of it. It started to leak at the end of last year. We had it filled. and then it lasted a month, and then it was right back to where it was, freezing up. So I already looked at a unit. It's double the size of what this one was. This one was underrated anyway, so it stayed going all the time. Smoked my meter. So now they're up to 14 SEER. This will be a 3-ton unit. It'll actually cost me less money to run it. And when someone looks at the house, it's a selling feature. Because I got 3 choices. They look at a broken unit, and the house is hard as hell, and you're sticky when you go inside it. They look at the house, it's cold. The engineer, or whoever comes to look at the house, says you're going to need an AC unit soon. And that's sticking in the back of their mind, thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars. Or they look at the house that has a brand new unit in it. And that's one thing checked off the list they don't go to think about. So when they start adding up the things they want to change in the house, because everybody does, that's not on the list. So that's the way we're going. Yeah. So we should see something like that. We should see what the next couple of weeks. I'm hoping. So with that said, the holiday's coming. I'm hoping to have a good 4th of July for the first time in a couple of years. The last two sucked, to say the least. But I think this one will be fine. I think this one will be just right. So, got 4 days off in a row, that's good. That's always good. And I'm hoping to do something. I'm trying to plan something right now as we speak. I got part of it planned out. So, that's really the important part. And we'll see. And if we do, of course, I'll take the camera with me.